What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today is all about Lenovo's ThinkSystem SR630V2, building a Proxmox lab. So let's get right into it. All right, so I have been sitting on this project for almost 6 months, and I finally decided to do the video for you guys. So I received a ThinkSystem SR630V2 from Lenovo to actually, you know, use it for my everyday stuff. And, you know, the time that I got it, that's when VMware was being bought out by, I think, Broadcast or Broadcom, whatever. And I wanted to, you know, test something out. I wanted to test something different. I was automatically going to install VMware into this machine, but I said, you know what? Let me play around with Proxmox. Hopefully I'm saying that right. So this is my little journey of building that out. So before I even start telling you guys how I built out this machine, let's go over some of the, you know, some of the ports and features of this machine. Now the SR630V2 at the front, you're going to see the VGA. I think this is a 3.0 USB port. That port right there, this I learned the hard way. This port is actually for management for your XClarity Mobile. And I think the other port right there is for your external diagnostics. On the left-hand side, you're going to get this. So Lenovo actually hooked me up with 4 NVMe 1.6 terabyte hard drives, which I was super happy, right? So automatically, I'm saying to myself, yes, we're going to create a nice little RAID 5 system on this. But I was a little disappointed, and I'll show you later. So removing one of these guys, you're going to see it is an Intel NVMe, awesome, beautiful 1.6 terabyte solid state drive. This guy is a beast running all those virtual machines that I build into this server, which eventually later on future videos, I'm going to show you guys all the virtual machines and how I built that stuff out. But for now, this is what I did for this server. At the back, they did provide me with a nice PCI card with 4 Ethernet ports. I also have the Ethernet port that's embedded on the motherboard. So I actually took advantage of a couple of these ports. On the right-hand side, we're going to get an additional VGA and more 3.0 USB ports. I think these are 3.0 USB ports. And as always, they gave me dual power supplies. I love dual power supplies because of redundancy. These power supplies are 750 watts. Now, opening this guy up, a lot of memory. I did have some issues on this server. 2 of the memory sticks went bad on me, and it got to the point that the server, same thing, was rebooting automatically on me. It wasn't like, it just like, everything was running with no problem. It did not give me a warning issue when I restarted the machine. I went into the event logs, no problem. But like the next day, it rebooted. And I know it rebooted because all my virtual machines were shut down. So I had to locate the memory sticks that were bad. Once I removed the memory sticks, there was no problem. Cool thing is that the SR630, right? The SR630, I'm looking at my notes because I forget. The SR630 has dual processors, which is awesome. Memory sticks, each one is 32 gigs. I forgot how much memory I get in total, but it is a lot of memory. These are the 8 swappable 28K RPM fans. I don't know the exact size of them, but they're really loud. Inside the motherboard embedded, there is a USB. You are able to insert a USB, which I actually did, but I did not take advantage of it during the process of installing Proxmox on this machine. Now, for this setup, I did like a nice isolated network. I had a hotspot, and the hotspot is configured and hooked up into the Netgear, and the server, that yellow cable is hooked up to the Netgear to give it, to give it internet access. And then in the back, I have a video capture card so I could capture all the information, especially to capture some of the B-roll that I'm going to show you guys when I went into the system setup, as well as setting up the Proxmox. So that is how I captured everything behind the scenes. Keyboard and mouse was set up at the front, so I'm able to, you know, start the installation process and press F11 as well as F12 to do the one-time boot. Once all that stuff is set up, I needed to do a little bit of legwork, and the legwork was to download Proxmox. I opened up the browser and I typed in Proxmox and I did a Google search. It took me here. I clicked on download Proxmox server. It took me here. Now, the time that I did this, again, it took me a long time for me to actually do this video for you guys, 6 months. And the Proxmox version that I downloaded was 8.1. Most likely, there's a newer version, and I'm going to show you guys later on how to upgrade your Proxmox. So that's killing two birds with one stone. I'm going to show you guys how to do that, which is great. And I'm going to learn how to do it because I am not a Proxmox user. First time using it in a lab and like vetting everything out. So I learned a lot from it. So from here, I'm going to click on download. I'm going to drop it into the downloads folder. So I'm going to click on save and boom, it's saved with no problem. And we're going to open up the downloads folder and there goes our ISO image. Now we have our image. It is time for us to create a bootable drive. This bootable drive is what we're going to insert into our SR630, right? SR630. Got it right. Boom. We're going to insert that USB drive so we can boot into it and install the operating system. For this process, I had two flash drives. Boom. Awesome. Now, during this build, I wanted to do the following, and that's the reason why I had these two flash drives. I'm going to tell you guys my game plan. I wanted to install the Proxmox image into one of these flash drives, and the other flash drive, I wanted to install the operating system into that. So the SR630 would boot into the flash drive, but I learned the hard way. Proxmox does not like that at all. So I had to change my plans to get it up and running, but I still needed to create the bootable flash drive. I opened up Rufus. I inserted the flash drive into my laptop. This is the one that I inserted into my laptop. It picked it up. The D drive, 16 gigs. I clicked on select. I went into the downloads folder. I picked the Proxmox ISO image. I clicked on open. It gave me this. I clicked OK. Give it some time. I clicked on start. It's going to give me a nice little warning that it is going to destroy everything within that flash drive. Sure. OK. Yes, this flash drive, I've used it for multiple partitions. So this is the reason why I got this warning. So I clicked OK here and it started writing the image. Once it finished, ready, I clicked on close, boom. So what I did is I took the flash drive. This flash drive here is the one that I want to install the operating system into. I was debating whether to either insert it at the back or inside, but at the end, I decided to do the following. So the SanDisk is the one that I'm going to install the operating system. The PNY is the one that we created a bootable flash drive out of. And like I said before, I learned the hard way. Proxmox does not like this setup at all. Trust me. So I actually had to use one of the NVMe hard drives that's part of the SR630 for it to work properly. This setup is no bueno, no good at all. Trust me. All right. So it's time for us to configure our RAID. So I booted the machine. I clicked on F1 for system setup. And I'm going to show you guys what I did right here. Quick B-roll. It's going to load up the X-Clarity Provisioning Manager. I went into the RAID setup and Lenovo sent me the SR630 without a RAID controller, which sucked. Oh, damn. So I wasn't able to create a RAID out of the four hard drives that I got on that machine. No RAID controller, but it is time for us to configure our boot setup so we can boot into the USB and start the installation. So for that, I did a little bit of B-roll, got some B-roll. So I went into the UEFI setup. From here, I went into the boot manager. I clicked on add a generic boot option. I clicked on USB storage. Boom. And from here, I clicked on save. A little lag when I was capturing everything. I clicked on yes here. It started saving all the settings. Perfect. At the top, I exit and I clicked OK. And the machine started rebooting. Now, once you reboot, Make sure you press F12 to do a one time and just select your flash drive, and it's going to automatically boot into the Proxmox installation process. It went too fast, but I'm going to go back real quick for you guys. First one is this. So I selected the first option, the graphical interface. Then you get the license agreement. So just make sure on the lower right-hand side, you click on I agree. Once you click on I agree, you need to select your target, your hard disk, where you want to install it. Like I said, I had to pick one of the NVMe hard drives. When I learned the hard way, I had to do everything over. But for this B-roll, I picked the flash drive that I inserted. I picked that SanDisk and I clicked on next. And then you have to pick your country, your time zone, and your keyboard layout, and then click on next. Then you provide a password and confirm the password and also provide an email. Now, this password is basically your root password that allows you to log into your Proxmox. And once you provide all that information, you are able to click on next. Like right now, I'm providing the email information. So click on next. And then from here, you are going to choose your management interface. Give it a host name, give it an IP, a gateway, and your DNS server. Configure all that information. And once you're done, click on next. Once you're done, you're satisfied, we're going to click on install. Once you click on install, it's going to start installing the operating system into your hard disk. Now, like I said before, I learned the hard way. I had to do everything over because Proxmox does not like being installed into a flash drive. So I had to do everything over and pick one of the NVMe hard drives for it to work properly. Once it reboots and it's done, you're going to get this right here. It should give you the IP address with a colon and the port, which the default port is 8006. Now, once you have the URL to log into your Proxmox, it is time for us to load up a browser. You're gonna load up the browser and you're going to type in your IP address with that port of 8006. Once you enter it, hit enter. You're going to get the following. Your connection is not private. It's okay. Click on advanced. Click on proceed to whatever IP address your server is assigned to. Click on that. Takes you here. It loads up. It wants you to enter the username and password. So the username and password will be root and whatever password you provided during the installation process. And then click on login. As soon as you do that, it's going to give you the following. No valid subscription. You are able to click OK on that. From here, I clicked on my data center, which I don't think that's called a data center, but I expanded my data center, and then you're able to see all your local hard drives. And that's it, guys. Hopefully, you guys enjoyed this video, and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.